Hey guys, good morning. My name is Matthew Alcober and welcome to the video. Let's go. Kanina tapos na tayo mag-coffee. Syempre morning coffee, we need the caffeine para mamaya pa mag-workout na tayo. And in this video, we're about to get real, making serious tayo about sa topic ng video na to. You read the title, it's all about recycling your pain. To be honest guys, matagal ko na talaga tong gustong i-topic tong video na to about sa using your past as motivation, recycling your pain, or any other stuff, because I believe na kailangan to, because I have a, sabihin natin, hindi magandang background in the past, mga situations, events, mga nangyayari, and I believe sa mga viewers na nanonood ngayon, you have the same thing too. So, I created this video for you to know first that you're not alone. Second is, what are the ways that I personally use to use it as fuel and not let it break me. So, ayun guys. With that said, bago tayo mag-straight dun sa topic na yun, mag-meditate muna tayo syempre. And at the same time, we're gonna do some journaling para i-remind ko sa sarili ko of what I am, my purpose, my mission, and at the same time, para I tap in a state of flow, para hindi ako mag-sway-sway whenever I feel like this, feel like that. No, we're being calm, grounded, rational, and of course, direct. But with that said, we're gonna do some meditation and journaling. Let's go, time lapse. So ayun guys, tapos na tayo mag-meditation and at the same time, tapos na rin tayo mag-journaling. And nakaka-refresh. Kanina habang nagme-meditate ako, hindi ako ma-relax because I feel that my mind is going from this state to this state. Pinapagana yung the monkey mind. And na-speak na natin sa last video natin, last video about dun sa monkey mind. And guys, I am not perfect. I experience negative emotions and at the same time, I feel anxious as well. I'm a human. Pero at the same time, I walk the talk, I walk what I preach, I do what I've done nung sinabi ko sa video. I meditate and I focus myself on the present moment, and at the same time, habang nag-journaling ako, mas lalo ako na-refresh because I do the method yung Think of someone you admire and isipin mo kung ano yung sasabihin nila sa'yo if you would give in a chance to meet them on a one-on-one. And si Miyamoto Musashi, siyang swordsman. And binapanood ko kasi dun sa isang YouTube yung The Way of the Ronin, The Way of Ultimate Focus, about dun kay Miyamoto Musashi. And hindi ko na i-explain kung ano yung about story niya, pero grabe, grabe yung mga ideas and perspective na nakuha ko dun sa philosophy na yun. And ang kailangan natin gawin is to apply it on the everyday basis. So ngayon guys, tapos na tayo mag-meditation and journaling. Right now, syempre, favorite ko to, we're gonna do some home workout, bago tayo mag-dive in sa topic natin. So let's go, sasama ko kayo, workout, let's go, bye-bye. correct, guys. Workout done, workout complete. We're rocking the red shirt. Boom, boom, boom. Let's go. Tapos na tayo maligo. Tapos na rin tayo mag-workout. Tapos na tayo maglinis lahat. Male grooming. And at the same time, tapos na rin tayo minom ng multivitamins as well. So, ayun. Alam niyo na yung sasabihin ko? Paulit-ulit natin itong ginagawa and I hope na paulit-ulit nyo rin itong ginagawa. Do not forget to drink your multivitamins and at the same time, do not forget to drink your water as well para healthy tayo and strong from the inside. Let's go. And at the same time, strong, healthy, and glowing tayo from the outside. Let's go. Yan. Tapos na tayo mag-workout at maglinis. So, ayun guys, we're gonna dive in sa topic natin. So, nabasa niyo yung topic natin is recycle your pain. Because I believe na every one of us, including me, every one of us, there's a sad story behind. And I know na sometimes it haunts you. And syempre, pag naalala mo yun, nagpa-flashback lahat and things are rough. Bibigay ko na yun sa akin. Sa akin, ako naman is dati nung mga elementary high school, I was bullied for being fat. I was being making fun of. So being fat, I mean, super tabako. Yung teacher ako dati. Lalagay ko dito. And then, and pagka inaano ko yung time na yun, things are rough. As in, things are rough. And I believe na I'm not alone. There are people rin out there na right now they were being bullied for being fat. That's beta shit, to be honest. Ngayon na-realize ko na the problem is not me, but rather the problem is in them because they are so insecure about themselves na to the point na they're, alam mo yun, they're looking at your flaws and then pointing at your flaws at hindi nila tinitignan yung sa sarili nila. So right now, we're talking about recycling your pain. Hindi ko malalam kung ikaw, I don't know what about, kung ano nangyari sa'yo in the past. Maybe you've been bullied. Two, maybe you've been making fun of kasi skinny ka, mataba, or what, or anything. Anything sad background. And I'm gonna tell this to you to recycle your pain. Use that situation. Use that event na nangyari sa'yo. That's pretty tough, I know, but use it as fuel. Use it as fuel to better yourself. You can't change the past. You can't change what happens yung nangyari nun. You can't change it. But rather, you can change what you do right now. That will make a difference papunta rin sa future mo. I know things are rough right now. Marami nag-flashback, including me sometimes. I flashback yung mga nangyari sa akin. Pero, as I look back, hindi na ako tulad nung dating ako. Right now, ang masasabi ko, I'm thankful na nangyari yun. I know it's weird, pero sinasabi ko sa akin, I'm thankful na binuli nila ako dati. And I'm thankful na minikfan nila ako. Alam mo kung bakit? I'm thankful kasi kung hindi nangyari yun, hindi ako aabot sa kung ano, kung ako ngayon. I'm using that situation as fuel. I'm using that situation as energy. I know I am not that kind of person because I know sa sarili ko na I'm the best. And you know sa sarili mo na you're the best also. That's what about recycling your pain. It's not about dwelling on the past and what will happen, but rather focusing on the solution rather than the problem. Ito na yung problem. Ito na yung problem. Mataba ako nun. Mataba ako nun. Tatanggapin ko na talaga yun. Now, ang kailangan kong i-focus is the solution. How can I lose weight? How can I build muscle? How can I achieve a coldest physique? And at the same time, how can I be mentally strong, spiritually strong, and emotionally strong? Yun yung kailangan mong i-focus. Not dwelling on what happens, on what happened on the past. The past is rough, I know. But you can recycle your pain. Now, right now, I'm gonna ask you this one thing. What will you do with your pain? Nakuha ko to kay Eric Thomas and it hit me in the face as him. At na-realize ko na, alam mo yun, there's no need for me to dwell on that shit. That shit happened. That's the, alam mo yun, ang rough nun. That shit rough. Pero at the same time, I can focus on now. So I'm gonna ask you this, what will you do with your pain? What will you do with your pain? Would you let it break you? Kasi it's a choice. Would you let it break you? Or would you let it redefine you? Or use it as fuel for your overall growth? So I'm talking to you right now. The past is rough. Hindi mo na kayang baguhin yun. You can't change what happened on the past. But right now is what matters. The old, it does not matter na yan. What matters is what are you doing right now to better yourself 1% better every single day. Despite yung nararamdaman mo to, despite yung nararamdaman mo yan, you kept on going. I know the past will haunt you at your back. Ako nafe-feel ko rin yun sometimes. I am not perfect. But I chose to keep on going and use that as fuel and recycle my pain. Because my past don't need me, but rather my future needs me. And what I do now affects what I'm gonna be in the future. So I need to keep on going and at the same time recycle my pain. I believe rin na every one of us has their own greatest potential on the inside of themselves. Hindi lang nila makita yun. So what I'm gonna tell you right now is use your pain, recycle your pain. Don't dwell on it, learn from it, and grow from it. Looking in the past ain't matter. Until you will look back on your past and you're gonna learn something. You're gonna learn to endure, you're gonna learn to set boundaries, and at the same time, you're gonna learn to get stronger and to improve yourself every single day. Recycle your pain. I believe there's the greatest in you. So, ito medyo personal tong ginawa ko tong video na to. I'm not giving any tips. I'm not
there's
giving
no internet
advice.
Connection at the moment.
I'm not giving any advice. Personal na talaga sa akin tong video to. I wanna encourage you to recycle your pain. Don't let it break you, but rather let it redefine you and use it for your overall growth. Don't focus on the past. Focus on developing the new, which is what you do right now that will affect your future. So yun lang guys, this is very personal to me. If umabot mga kayo kasi sa video na to, give a thumbs up, click subscribe, and click the notification bell to my channel. You're strong and I believe in you. All we can do is to accept na nangyari na yun, adapt, and overcome. Accept, adapt, and overcome. Stay safe, stay strong, stay healthy, and most importantly, stay macho.